Hello everyone. I wanted to show how I do my embossing. I just want to say I've never taken any classes and I have never actually seen anybody do this. I have taught myself from hit and miss. And if you're looking for a professional embosser, this is not the place to find that. I'm just going to show you how I do it and what works for me. So I have a very old embossing ink pad. It used to be a nice clear color. It's now black from all my dirty stamps and stuff. It still works, so I still use it, and when it doesn't work anymore, I'll buy a new one. But until then, this is what I'm using. I do use two pieces of paper underneath my work. You really only need one. I'm really messy, so I have two just so I can be just a little neater and collect a little bit more of the embossing powder when it falls. I'm gonna do quite a few different kinds of paper. We'll start out with just a normal piece of paper. I like to use, and again, I've had this embossing powder for over 10 years, at least 10 years, way over 10 years. So I don't even know if some of these brands are still around. So I'm just going to use what I have. Like I said, I'm just trying to use stuff up before I buy new stuff. My first embossing powder that I really like, it's a black one and it's ultra detail. I like it because some of the stamps that I use have a lot of detail, and I will show you the difference right now. Let's see. Well, let's just do a basic embossing. We'll do a fish because everybody likes the fish. So I ink up my image really well. If you have a brand new embossing ink pad, you will not be able to see where you have stamped on your paper. So make sure that you have gotten all your image nice and saturated with lots and lots of ink. Because if you've got a brand new one and you go to, I'm going to do it sideways. If you go to ink that, I can see mine because mine's tinted black now. And sometimes you can see it, just the wetness of that. I'm going to use my ultra detail, my favorite one in black. I sprinkle the embossing powder over the entire stamped image. I put quite a bit there so that it is all covered. Okay. And then I kind of tap it a little bit so I know that I've gotten all my little spaces. And it's all the stamp on the outside edges. Everything is covered with some embossing powder. And I put my still opened embossing thing back, kind of bend the paper a little bit, and kind of let that embossing powder flow back into it so I can use what is not there. So I have got quite a mess going on here. As you can see, I've got powder everywhere. I tap the paper lightly with my finger, and that seems to release quite a bit of that powder. You can see that image pretty much cleaned itself up by just tapping. I must have touched this paper a little bit. I guess there are tools out there to help corral loose powder like that. I just use a brush. I'm not real particular about if my images aren't exact, if they're not crisp. If they've got a little bit of meandering powder around, I'm not bothered so much by that. I'm not looking for an exact exact embossing image. I use a lot of these for collage and stuff like that. I just want an image of the fish. So I tap that down. I don't tap it too much. The more you tap it, the more powder will come off, the less image you will have, the less powder you will have to melt to make your image. So I just tap it a few times very lightly, put it aside. I'm gonna put that aside without letting it touch anything else. And I've got powder on my paper here. And this is the reason I use two, is I've got the top one that I can put the rest of that powder back into the thing. And then, of course, I haven't gotten all of it, so there's still more here. I usually tap that into the garbage. I make sure my lid is over because this is really easy to spill and make a huge mess. And then when I'm using different powders, I will take these two pieces of paper to the garbage and wipe them off, make sure that there's no powder on them. I do not emboss. I'm going to bring my image back. I do not emboss directly down onto my surface, only because I have a plastic craft mat that will melt. So I can't do that. I have to lift my image up. So I take one of my pieces of paper with my piece of embossing paper that I have, that is embossed. Sorry, words. I need words. I lift it up in the air, and I use this second piece underneath just to make it more stable. I use a heat gun, and this is an old one. I don't think they make this anymore from what I understand. It's the one I've had forever, and it's the one I will continue using until it doesn't want to work anymore. It doesn't blow out very much air, so your embossing powder does not fly everywhere. I'm going to turn this on, and I'm going to try to lift it up to the camera so you can kind of see as the hot air is hitting the embossing image. You can kind of see the embossing powder melting and sticking to the paper. So hopefully we can see that. All right. Let's start from one end. And I can see that it is melting, and I'm going to make sure that I am covering the entire image, going from one end to the other, and making sure that all that powder is melted and it is on there really well. And that's about all the time that's needed. Some powders do take a little bit more time, but you should be able to see in person as it's melting that you've got it all done. Don't touch the image right after you've done it. It's hot. You'll burn yourself. It does cool down fairly quickly. It's okay now. But you can see that image is kind of shiny. And it's all on there. I can touch the entire image and I don't feel any powder at all, none at all. It's all melted in. Sometimes if you don't get some of the edges and stuff, you can rub away the powder. You can't really re-ink it because you won't be able to get your image exactly where you had it before, and you'll get a blurred image. So that was the ultra detail. And you can see that it's all got really nice detail to it. Now I'm going to show you with the same stamp another one that I have. And it doesn't say a whole lot of anything. I don't even know what brand it is. I don't have another black one. This is the closest I have to black. And it's like a pearly black, I think. But it's not quite as detailed as my ultra detail one. So again, I'm going to stamp or ink up my stamp really, really well. And before it dries, I am going to stamp that image. I am very careful about placing my stamp. Don't move it around. The embossing powder will stick to anything that is wet. The ink makes the paper wet where you want the embossing powder to stick. So if you put your stamp all over the place, that's where all this embossing powder is going to stick itself, and you don't want that. So make sure that you're stamping fairly clearly, and don't rock your stamp. Make sure that it's the image is good. Okay, so I'm gonna put the stamp away, and I am going to sprinkle over this other embossing powder. It's so old, it's got clumps. Big clumps. And let me get that big old clump out of the way. I tap it just a little bit, just so that moves the powder over the wet image, and to make sure that all the wet image has a little bit of powder on it. And I want to make sure that I got all my outsides as well, all his fins and all that other stuff. And then I am going to bend my paper so that it makes it kind of a funnel. And I am going to put that back into my jar. I'm going to tap it just a little bit and get that excess off. Put that to the side. And I am going to clean off my underpaper here just a little bit. And this is messy for me. I'm probably not doing it the right way. I always get powder everywhere. It's why I use two pieces of paper. I'm closing my thingy, my container, and I'm going to take this to the garbage and just shake them off, just so I have a clean piece of paper for the next time. All right, so carefully I'm bringing this back, and I need to do the second image, and I'm going to do the same thing. Maybe you can see it melting. This time I'm just going to do the same exact thing. I start from one end and I go all the way to the other end, make sure I get the outsides as well. So able to see that one just a little bit more. You could see how the image was changing as the powder melted. But as you can tell, if we get a close-up of it, let's see if we can get it to focus. 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 There we go. The top one is my ultra fine embossing powder. You can see all the little fins and the details and stuff. And when you get to the other one, it's not quite as detailed. It's a little bit more, what's the word? It's not as fine. The powder is not as fine, so it clumps up just a little bit more. The image is still good, but there is a little bit of a difference. You can see. All right, and that's I like the ultra fine when I'm doing images, you know, like these wings. If there it's an extra fine image that's got little tiny face parts or things like that, the ultra fine will make sure that you can see all the details in your stamp. But for other things like this one, it's fine. It's not, I like to use colors and stuff, and I don't really care if it's clumpy or not. So that is the normal embossing. That's just how I emboss my images, and I do all kinds of, well, see, now I didn't get it all melted there, and as I rubbed off some of his face. So you do have to be careful that you get it all. Oh, I can't redo that, so I'm stuck with a fish that's kind of got part of a face missing. I could probably go in there with a pen or something, but you need to be careful and do it slowly and make sure that you've got all your embossing powder melted, okay? I also emboss images on tissue paper, and people have asked how I manage to do tissue paper. It's a little bit more tricky. Tissue paper is much more fine, and it's harder to deal with. Because the embossing will go through and kind of stick to the paper underneath. But we're going to use the ultra detail again, and let's do the sun so you can see what's going on. So I am going to ink up my image really, really well, make sure it's very, very, very saturated with ink. I am going to put this tissue on, I'm going to put my image on the edge of my tissue. I will do a whole, it's a big piece of tissue, I cut it down, and I mean it's not huge, but it's big enough, and I will do all the images on tissue paper at one time, and I'll tell you why. Tissue paper is very, very flimsy. Let me put the powder on while it's still wet. Sprinkle, sprinkle all over my image. Let me put that right there. And I don't want to move the tissue paper too much because that it's so fragile that the embossing powder will not adhere real well. The more I shake it, the more embossing powder comes off, and the less image you're going to have. I've got a fingerprint right there, so I am going to brush off that fingerprint. I don't know what I did. I guess I put my finger on the tissue and there was just enough sweat or oil on my fingers that it stuck to that. And I kind of brushed too close to the image. So I'm going to put that aside and put the rest of this inside there. Close up my container and get it out of the way so it doesn't get any heat. The trick for tissue paper is to have it up against another piece of paper. This paper is so flimsy. Do not get your heat gun underneath it because it'll start flying around and your embossing powder will just fly right off of it. Now you've got all kinds of embossing powder all the way around that. You want to make sure you don't have embossing powder where you don't want it, because it will melt and you'll be stuck with it wherever it is. And I think I am moving the embossing powder off the tissue, and that's where it's coming from. So this is what I do. I hang on to an opposite corner of the tissue paper, make sure that it's well anchored on a piece of paper, and I make sure that I go right above the image so that I don't get air underneath it, and I will show you at the end what I mean by getting air underneath it after the embossing is embossed and it won't come off. All right, and I, like I said, I have to hold mine up because I've got a plastic mat underneath there and I don't want it to melt. So, if you get your embossing to get underneath it like that, you're gonna, and you haven't embossed it yet, you're gonna lose your powder. So don't get it to flop around like that. The paper underneath really secures it, makes it strong enough so that you can do your embossing, and it's not gonna go anywhere. A lot of times I have found that tissue paper is so thin that when you put your ink on there, sometimes your embossing will stick to the bottom paper. It doesn't stick very hard or very long. You can easily lift it off, but sometimes it'll stick just a little bit. So that is our first image on tissue paper. And the reason I hold it opposite corner is, and the reason I do a large sheet at one time is because that gets hot. If you have your finger trying to hold the paper real close, you're gonna burn yourself. That embossing gun, it's meant to put out a lot of heat to melt these powders. It will burn you, so please be careful of your embossing tool. Make sure that you're putting it in a place where it's cooling down. It's got a little, mine has a little arm that I can set. It doesn't like to set because the cord is twisted and it usually rolls around. I don't trust it anymore. I have it in a hot paper cup, a hot coffee cup that I just put it in a box, so I can grab it really easily. But you should be able to put your heat gun down because that gets, the tip of that gets really, really hot. You will burn yourself if you touch it. It will burn anything that you put it onto. So be a little careful with your heat tool. All right. So, like I said, I usually do a whole piece of tissue paper at one time so that I can just use all of my tissue paper and not burn myself. And then I've got a bunch of pieces of tissue paper with either the same image or with different images on. I have one here that I did. So I can do another image. And then I always make sure that I heat mine because I've used different colors. If you put all of your stuff on there and then heat it up, you're gonna lose stuff. So I do them all one at a time. And then you have little bits of tissue paper to cut off and you can use in your collages or your cards or whatever you're doing. Here's a tree that I embossed on tissue paper. I used matte medium and just glued it down. You can kind of see if we can get it focus. You can kind of see the images underneath it. Usually the tissue paper will melt into the background. I don't know if I used enough matte medium, but you can still see what's underneath it, and that's kind of what I like about that. The reason I like to do my images on a tissue paper or a separate piece of paper is if you're trying to emboss on pieces of paper like this that have edges, your inked image is not going to be very clear. It's going to be a little broken up, and you're not, might not be happy with it. This image I did on a piece of deli paper, same kind of thing. You need to have a piece of paper underneath it so that you can brace the paper a little bit as it's getting melted. That's tissue paper, deli paper. You can emboss on magazine images. The glossy paper sometimes doesn't want to take the ink. Be real careful when you're stamping your image on a glossy piece of paper. That stamp kind of shifts a little bit as you're pressing down. So try to be, you know, try not to let it shift at all. But it ends up being kind of interesting sometimes. You can also emboss images, where I like to emboss images on different pieces of kinds of paper. This one's a metallic. And I should probably show how to do metallics and stuff. And you can emboss on envelopes. I like the way embossing is very opaque, so that if you emboss on top of something else, you're going to get your image that's fairly clear. Come on. Anyway, sorry, it's just not wanting to focus. There it goes. There it goes. All right, so you can see that the pattern of the paper underneath is covered up by the embossing. So it's kind of fun to do things on patterned paper, scrapbook paper, on magazine images, or I also do stuff on book pages, which is fun to use in collage and stuff. I sometimes print out patterns and stuff on paper and emboss on that just for something different. The sky's the limit. Any kind of paper, it's kind of fun to try out and to do. I have embossed on maps. Don't have any of that right now. You can ink up your paper before you emboss on it. Just make sure that before you put your image on there that all the ink underneath or all the paint or whatever you're embossing on is dry. That embossing powder will stick to anything that is wet. So another thing that I really like to do is emboss on black paper. I like to use metallics this way. I have some glitter embossing. Glitter gets everywhere. Kind of saved it for the end because it's very messy. But I do like the images of the metallic on black. We can do one real fast. It's the same thing. Let's do a tree. Let's do a big tree. Let's do a big tree, and we'll do I'll do a metallic bronze. What do I have here? I've got a silver. I haven't used the silver yet. Let's make a silver tree. Let's make it snowy. See what it does. All right. I'm going to put it down here. Make sure that I got it well stamped. Make sure I've got powder everywhere. I got clumpy powder. It is old. It shouldn't be that way, but I am going to use it until it doesn't work anymore or it's gone. Putting the rest back in here. Tap it just a little bit. And it looks like I've got some red in there. So last time I used this, which I don't even know when, because I haven't used it in years. And that's why I use two different pieces of paper. If you're using different colors, you want to make sure that each paper is completely clean before you get a different color out, because you'll be putting your embossing powders together. You'll be mixing them. And they won't be as clear and nice and good. So that's what happened. And I've got a couple little red flecks in there. I can see it. You probably can't see it. But as you can see, it's kind of gray. It's not real nice yet. Let's get the gun out and see what it looks like as it melts. See if I can get it up here. All right. Don't know how much of that you could see, but now that it's all melted, you can see it's shiny and shimmery, and it wasn't that way before. It was kind of a gray, ucky kind of color, and now I've got this really wonderful silver tree on black. That's really fun to do something with. So we'll do one more. I can show you how to do show you some of the glitter ones. I think I've got a red glitter. I don't like to use it. Actually, I've got a gold glitter. Let's see what the gold glitter looks like on this butterfly. And I'm going to use the other end of this. Gold glitter, and that it looks exactly like glitter. It's called embossing and tinsel, and this stuff makes a terrible mess. I get it everywhere. So that's my image. Sprinkle some of this stuff on the entire image. Kind of make sure that it's sticking to all the places it should. Kind of wiggling it around a little bit, and then bending my paper so I can get it right back into the container. And I got it everywhere. Don't want to flick it too much because I'll take all that off. I'll put it on the side over here as I try to clean up this mess. Gonna have glitter everywhere now. And I am taking that directly to the garbage. Get rid of all I can. Okay, and now I am going to put a heat gun to it. See if we can see it melting. This one, it takes the detail of the stamp away quite a bit, but at least we still have the shape of the butterfly. It's not, if you've got a lot of detail to your stamp, you really don't want to do the glitter ones. You won't be able to see what you're doing. And I like to do the glitter ones a lot because it's harder to tell if it's actually melted or not. So I do it an extra long time, just so that I'm sure that it's all stuck and melted and going to stay on that paper. And there it is. Take a look at that. It's still really hot, so I can't touch it. But it looks fairly good. It's nice and shimmery. This is fun to do on gold wrapping paper. You could put silver on a gold wrapping paper or anything like that, and you have more images that are gold and silver to use in those accordion books that we were doing before. So that is pretty much everything that I do with tissue paper. And then at the end, I put in all my little pieces in my embossing basket so that when I'm collaging, I have images that I can choose if I want to include something like that. So I emboss on all kinds of different kinds of paper, envelopes and book pages and tissue and maps and writing and, you know, whatever I can find. So that's what I've got in here. I have inked over some of them. I emboss first and then ink over sometimes. Sometimes I'll just do a lot of embossing on white paper, and I can put ink or watercolor over it when I decide what color I want it to be. Here's some embossing done on a magazine page. It was just a piece of color page that I liked the color of, so I added a little bit of something. And this one too is just a little bit of embossed pattern on there. So I hope you have some fun. Here's another magazine book page that I embossed that I can add color to later. So that is what I do. Like I said, I don't think it's exactly correct, But it works for me. It's not exact images sometimes, but they work well enough, and I do enjoy using these images in my collages and stuff. It's a little bit harder. You can collage into a book, but it's a little bit more difficult to maneuver the book and everything else. So I like to collage on single pieces of paper and then put them where I want them. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching.